Hello students, let's try to start unit number 4, that is triangulation adjustment and theory of errors. So first let's have some and try to understand some basics. Then first point, that is types of error. First it is mistakes. Mistakes are errors that arise from inattention, inexperience, carelessness and poor judgment or confusion in the mind of the observer. Second, systematic errors. Systematic error is an error that under the same conditions will always be of same size and sign. A systematic error always follow the some definite mathematical or physical law and corrections to be determined and applied. Third, accidental errors. Accidental errors are those which remains after mistakes and systematic errors have been eliminated and are caused by a combination of series reasons beyond the ability of observer to control. Next, that is most probable value. The most probable value of a quantity is the one which has more chances of being true than any other. Most probable error. The most probable error is defined as that quantity which added to and subtracted from the most probable value fixes the limits within which it is an even chance that the true value of measured quantity must lie. True value. The true value of a quantity is the value which is absolutely free from all kinds of errors. Next, the weight of an observation. The weight of an observation is a number giving an indication of its precision and trustworthiness or its importance when making a comparison between the several available quantities of different words. Principle of least square. According to the principle of least squares, the most probable value of an observed quantity available from a given set of observations is the one for which the sum of square of the resulted errors is minimum. So let's try to start the new point in the unit number 4, that is triangulation adjustment and theory of errors. So our first and basic intention behind this concept, behind this unit, that we are having a number of observation and number of values which are collected from the various surveys, but our intention is to find the most precise value for the physical angle or for that particular station. We are going to conduct the number of observation, number of readings on same station, but that selected value, selected angle must be accurate. So we can consider the different types of errors in these observation, that is mistakes, systematic errors, accidental errors. Then the most probable value, it means it is the value which has maximum chances to be accurate or to be true. Then true value means it is the value which is the accurate and it is free from all kinds of errors. Then the weight of an observation, it means the weight for any observation indicates the importance of that observation. If the weight or the weightage of particular observation it is higher as compared to the other readings, it simply indicates that first value, it has more importance, it has more accuracy, it has more trustworthiness as compared to the other reading. So during the finalization, we can consider that value with maximum weightage. And principle of least square, it is also used to find the normal equation and to find or to make the equation. According to the principle of least square, the most probable value of an observed quantity available from a given set of observations. So here that set is important, is the one for which the sum of square of residual error, the sum of square of the residual error is minimum. So we can focus on the set of observations and we can select that value with the minimum error. So let's try to understand what is the normal equation. So you can study this part from the surveying volume 2 book by B.C. Punia. It starts from page number 289. A normal equation is that one which is formed by multiplying each equation by the coefficient of unknown whose normal equation is to be found and adding the equation to form as the number of normal equations is the same as the number of unknowns. The most probable value of the unknown can be found from the equations. So what is normal equation? The normal equation is one in which it is formed by multiplying each equation by the coefficient of unknown. Whose normal equation is to be formed, and then by adding the equation thus form. So we can form the normal equation by multiplying the coefficient of unknown terms, algebraic coefficient of unknown terms, and then we can find that equation, we can form that equation. For example, consider a round of angles observed at central station, the horizon closing with three angles, particularly x, y and z, which are geometrically fixed by the condition of equation. So if we add three angles, that angle, summation of angle, it is 360 degrees. If all the angles are of equal weights and errors e in the round will be, if we consider the equal weightage of all three readings and error e in that equation, so we can find that from the most probable value of each angle can then be obtained by applying a correction. If weightage is same, then we can equally divide this e or error into three values, that is 1 divided by 3, 2, or e divided by 3 to each observed angle. However, one angle is measured directly and others indirectly. The error equation takes from this form, e is equal to ax plus by plus cz plus d. So this is the basic or fundamental equation number 4, in which we need to divide this error equally into the three parts, and its error value represents its unknown coefficient or algebraic coefficient. If the measurements are repeated giving the different value, so if we are going to measure that angle number of times, so it is set of observations. Set of observations means x1 y1 z1, so it is the first reading for three angles, first set, second set and third set. Then we can form the equation, common equation or normal equation, with the help of three set of observations. So this is the e1 error in the first set, c2 e2 error in the second set, and e3 is the error in the third set. So it will continue up to the number of observation or number of sets. By the theory of Leet square, we can form this equation, summation of e square. So e is the error, that is summation of all set of observations, and it is summation of ax plus by plus cz plus d square should be minimum, and for which set this error is minimum, so we can say it is accurate. If we differentiate this equation with respect to x, y and z to form the normal equation, so if we differentiate this equation with respect to x, y and z, if we differentiating this in order with respect to x, y and z, the equation each expression so obtained to zero we get. So this is the normal equation for x, normal equation for y, normal equation for z. So equation number 2, 3 and 4. Equations 2, 3 and 4 are nothing but the fundamental equations, 1 multiplied by the coefficient of x, y and z respectively. If we multiply this fundamental equation with respect to x, y and z, then we will get this term, this equation. So we can say it is normal equation for x. If we multiply the first equation by x, the normal equation for x, and normal equation for y, normal equation for z. These equations are known as normal equations, the solution of which will be lead to the most probable value. So what is the use of normal equation? To find the most probable value, that is MPV. And based on the MPV, with respect to MPV, we can fix that rate. So thus equation 2 is the normal equation for x, equation 3 is the normal equation for y, and equation 4 is the normal equation for z. So equation, normal equation for x, y and z. Now if we consider this equation, the set of readings, similarly the set of readings, first set, second set and third set for all three readings, then also we can calculate the normal equation. So it is also possible to differentiate this equation with respect to the least square theory, or we can separately calculate this normal equation also with the help of summation. Hence, if the observations of equal weight, we derive the following rule for forming the normal equation. So if we consider the first set of observation, first theory, then we can make one rule, then we can form one rule. So this is the rule number one. It means to form the normal equation for each of the unknown quantities. So unknown quantities, that is x, y, and z. Multiply each observation's equation by the algebraic coefficient of that unknown quantity in that equation and add the result. So to form the normal equation of each of the unknown quantities, multiply the each observation equation by the algebraic coefficient of that unknown quantity in that equation and add the result. So if, however, each set of observation, the first, second and third set, if you consider, have different weights, that is w1, w2, w3. Okay, so in the first equation we can say that we can form that normal equation by multiplying the algebraic coefficient with the known quantities. Okay, so but this rule is applicable only if the weight is same, the weight of all these terms, it is same, all the observation, it is same. If the weight is same, then we can use, we can consider this first rule. So but what will happen if that weight is not same? That weightage result is not same. Ideally, we can take the minimum readings, and then we can, in that case, we can say that the weightage is same. But practically, it is not possible because we are going to conduct the number of observations or number of readings. So, in each case, that weightage will same. So, we must consider the weightage of the equation or weights of the equation to fix the normal to fix. Or to find the normal equation or to form the normal equation. So in second case, what will happen if, however, each set of observations 1, 2 and 3 have different weights, their importance weightage is different respectively. The error equation will take the following form. So here we need to form that equation with respect to weight. So for this error, first set of observation, that weight, it is different. For second set of observation, that weight, it is different. And for En, number of observation, that weight is Wn. By the theory of least square, we can say that if we use the same equation, and if we try to differentiate this equation with respect to x, y and z, try to obtain the normal equation for x, y and z, then also we can consider this weight. So again, the same concept. Equation 2, 3 and 4, equation 2, 3 and 4 are nothing but the fundamental equations of 1 multiplied by the coefficient of x, y and z in each term. These are the three form normal equations for x, y and z. But what is the rule in this case? To form the normal equation for each of the unknown quantities, multiply each observation equation by the product of algebraic coefficient of the unknown quantity in that equation and weight of that observation and add the result. So in the rule number one, we need to consider only the algebraic coefficient of unknown term, then at the end we can add this equation. But in the second rule, as per the second rule, to form the normal equation, we must consider the algebraic coefficient of the unknown term and then multiply that algebraic coefficient of unknown term by the weight of that equation. So it will also decide the importance of equation, weightage of the equation, as well as the normal equation. So we can consider the multiplication or product of the algebraic coefficient of the unknown quantity, that is ABC, and also the weight of that observation, and then at the end add this equation, so we will get the normal equation. So these are the two rules to form the normal equation. First rule, it is irrespective of weight, in that weightage is same. Second rule, it is with respect to weight. So thank you. I will stop here.